Welcome back, everybody. Today we're going to be opening 100 packs of Paradox Rift.
Okay, and we're back. I took all the booster boxes, broke them open, got the cards mixed up. That way we can kind of have an idea of what comes in the booster boxes. As far as pull rates, I am going to open up. I have two of the three packs. I'm going to open these ones up first. Okay, so we'll get into these ones first. Did notice I am up to 20, I believe it was 28 followers. I'll correct it somewhere on the screen. 28 followers now. So I'm getting closer. I believe that my goal is to hit 50, and I will do a small giveaway. So, if you like, you subscribe, and you comment, it'll help me get out there to get my 50. And that will also be, how you enter into the giveaway whenever I finally do it. And just so you know, one of these boxes wasn't a full box. I did take 14 packs out so I can make it a 100 pack opening. That was, of course, 8, so the math added up right, and then I took an additional 6 out so I can have these in this video. Oh, I got something good. Ooh, check that out. Iron Hands are ready. I'll take that. That's a pretty good card. Well, and I am working on a 100% master set of this set too. So you guys will end up seeing a binder eventually. More than likely, I will have a good bit of the cards after this video. I'll just have to take some time out so I can get these organized, get the binder set up, go pick up more sleeves because I doubt I have enough. You figure three packs of 30, or three booster boxes of 36 each. Plus, I did two Elite Trainer boxes at 9 each. Plus, I have these two 6 packs. It's too early for me to do math. I'm doing this video at like 7 o'clock in the morning, so somewhere in the video I'll have the number of how many packs in total I will have opened. By the way, I didn't do it yet. Check out the artworks for the booster packs. I kind of like them. Hang up the Elite Trainer Box Art 2 at some point. And I really gotta hang them all up. I don't have any of them hung up yet. Oh, there we go. Oh, Jim Powell. I forgot he was in this set. I do really like how they did the future cards and the ancient cards. It's pretty cool. Wu Chin. Man, I get sick for 1 week. And I'm going to carry this cough for what it feels like months now. I'm actually making this video the day after I posted the previous week's video. I went to the card break last night. I had a lot of fun. I got some more 151, but it looks like I didn't really get anything new, unfortunately. So I'll still be making my shorts where I open a pack a day. I actually just posted one of the shorts today. But hopefully I can get a little bit closer to completing that set. And the biggest one that still evades me is the Zapdos, the last one, the special art rare. Still trying to get my hands on that one. And I realized I don't have Daisy's Help full art. extremely weird. Iron Valiant. Is anybody planning on putting any of these cards into their new deck yet? Be interested to see some of the combinations coming out of this set. I have talked to a couple people, and from what I hear, the evolution and de-evolution card seems like it's going to be a pretty good set up in a deck. I hear people saying that they're going to try to figure out how to get that Iron Valiant in their deck. I'm kind of interested in maybe figuring out a way to get the Snorlax doll to work in my deck. Right now I have 6 decks and they're all torn apart. I'm trying to build them out with 151 now and figure out a way to make 151 work in all of them. Because there are some good cards in 151. I just haven't figured out. Oh, look at that Iron Hands again. Different one, but I just gotta figure out how I can fit them into my deck where they will be useful. I can't wait to see the combinations that come out of this set. From what I've seen so far, this set is insane. go against Sandy Sharks. I'm still amazed on how many legendaries and mythicals are actually in this set. It just blows my mind. Still PokeShop. That's where I buy everything at. Speaking of this shop, we actually just had a conversation last night about, I believe the count was at 8. 8 demigod packs from 151 was pulled from our shop. Kind of insane. Just making sure my camera's still on. Working on a better solution for my camera too. Trying to figure out what I can get. I mean, the solution I have been using was just tucking it like right here and having a shot of everything. But I have to sit back just a little bit further. And with me opening 100 packs today, I figured that would be super uncomfortable. So I have it back up in the air. I do not like having it up there because it seems like every move I make down here shakes that camera. Every move. Man, I'm really starting to like this no card trick thing that they got going on here. Makes it super easy to go through these sets. Man, this might be my first video that lasts an hour. Oh, there we go, Larry. Look at that. Burger. Norman, I believe I have Norman already though. But I'll take another one. Always need something for trades. Feels like it's a little thicker sound. Hopefully that means I get something good in this pack. Nope. Plus 18, that's 126. Plus another 6, that'd be 130. Hundred and thirty-two packs I will have opened by the end of this video. It's not going to be a complete set, but that will help knock a lot of it out. I should have at least one full page 100% complete after this, which will be nice. Oh, there's a gold card. Take a quick second, grab myself a drink, stretch, and then I will be back. And we're back. We have 60 packs left. I counted them while I took my break, stretched, got a drink. Means we're 40 packs in. We have 11 hits. One in four seems to be the way this set's going, which isn't too bad. I know with 151, my luck lately has been like 1 in 10. There we go. It seems like I'm not drawing anything good out of 151, and if I do draw something good, it's a switch, a gold switch, set of gold switches, working on a second one, unwillingly, but that happens. Hoping after this video, I will be able to come to you guys with a number of how many I need for this set, and it's under 800. Looks like I got something else here. Oh, it's the Mewtwo. I'm hoping to get a couple of these, because that would go really well in a psychic deck. Basic and discard piles of your Pokemon in any way that you like. Don't sit down. And this attack does 30 more damage for each energy attached to all of your Pokemon. So it's kind of a feeder. And its attack will, if you're feeding right, its attack will easily do some hefty damage. I don't think there is a decent feeder in Psychic yet, so. I know you got Baxcalibur for water, but I don't think there is one for psychic. I mean, I could be mistaken. There could be one out there that I probably have. I just didn't realize it. And if you're wondering why I haven't been doing prices on this, I don't feel that if I put prices out there, they will be accurate just yet, because the set is still kind of, I mean, came out last week. Prices haven't really, like, started to slow down. Still fluctuating like crazy. Hopefully, the next video I make for this set, Iron Valiant, look at that. Hopefully, the next video I make for this set, if I get anything good, I can put prices on it.
quick. I'm just going to move some of these over. Give myself a little bit more room. Don't worry, I'll pull them all out by the end. Didn't mess my hair up too much of that. Nope. I'll pull them all out for the end and get a count out of 100 packs what I got. I'm going to have a lot of fun sorting through these and trying to figure out what goes in the binders. Once I hit the point where I'm capable of trading, I have enough of this set. I mean, I will be trading for 151 at first, but I'll have enough in this set to do some damage at least. This should roughly be, I should be coming up on the 60 packs open. There we go. So that means I'll have 40 left. Roughly, it's 43, 44 right now. Kind of glad I'm giving myself a week to edit this. This is going to be a decently long video. It's definitely going to break 1 hour. feels like it's been a second since I got a hit. Frostless. Not a bad hit. I'm pretty sure I have a full set for the technical machine evolution now. So if I needed it for its use, I should definitely have it now. Seems like the de-evolution too. Yeah, no, I do have one of those. So, trade. Seems like my hit rate is starting to go down a little bit. I don't know, it might just be me, but it seems like it. I'm kind of curious of what the official chase cards will end up being from this set. What is everybody going to be chasing after? Garchomp. I actually do believe I heard a couple people saying the fuller Garchomp is going to be one of them, and Gimme Golem, I think it's called. The Cheese Stick Guy. That's what my wife likes to call him. Oh, she got some unique names. Nice to pull that Garchomp down. That full art. That artwork looks so good on it. I see my pull rate's going down, so now it's going up. these packs just seem like they're just, they're not made to get into. Tulip, I think is how you say that. Now I'll take a sip order. I'll always take a supporter card. It seems like there's always at least one that is considered a chase card. It's worth a little chunk of change, at least. Apom is in the set. It's one of my favorite Pokemon. Well, besides the basic ones. Of course, I like my Mewtwo. I like my Charizard. But if I pick one Pokemon that isn't one of the everybody's favorites, Apom. Okay. We're getting down to the last 20. Looking for the guard chomp. Or maybe the other art of Roaring Moon. That'd be pretty good too. The gold, gimme gold. Take the gold, gimme gold. Okay. Maybe I'm saying it wrong. The cheesesteak dude. Whatever one the cheesesteak dude is. Just go with that. Seam Gold. Oh, maybe that was my mistake. Goldingo, that's his name now. The Gold Goldingo card. No, I didn't. Look at that. Oh, wow, that looks good. Oh, that is a card. Iron Hands. I always take another one of those. I feel like someone I know will be like, oh, I need that for my deck. Closer to the end, and I still haven't seen my Garchomp, my Goldingo, I on, don't let me down. Give me that Garchomp, give me that Garchomp, give me that Garchomp, give me that Garchomp. I believe it is the special illusion rare. To our last pack right here. Let's see what we got here. It looks like that's it. So give me 1 second, and I will be back with a count, and we will see what the odds are for pulling any hits. We're back. I have a count now. It looks like we are looking at 14 double rares, so it's 14% you'll pull one of those. I have a 6 of my illusion rare, and a 6 of my ultra rare, so about 6% for each of those. Then I have 2 special illusion rare and 1 of my ultra rares, I believe it's hyper rare. So that's pretty much your odds of pulling what you get out of here. All together 29-ish%, so a little bit better than 1 every 4 packs, you can be getting a hit. That doesn't sound too bad. Okay, I believe that's it. I guess I'll catch you guys next week. Like, subscribe, follow. Or like, subscribe, and share, please. Comment if you don't mind. I appreciate it. Thank you very much, and I will see you guys next week.